Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the WNBA.
Hello and welcome. It's the WNBA here on 2K Sports. Tonight, it'll be the Chicago Sky going up against the Las Vegas Aces. From the 2K booth with Brian Banifatemi and Tim Swartz, I'm Blake Suniga. Thanks for coming along. Now, here's Williams. Pass to Wilson. And here's Cambage. Solid play on the low block, and that one's good.
Maybe the best in the paint in the entire world. Liz Cambage has the combo of height at 6'8", plus touch to just torch teams.
Here's DeShields. Now Dolson, defended by Cambage. Shot clock at 6. They get it back. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Another reason you want Dolson on your team. She can turn a missed basket into points. Tremendous effort on the boards.
Now here's Cambage. Pass to Wilson. Double team on Asia Wilson. Stolen by DeShields. Now Parker. No good there.
She's a very strong finisher, guys. I'm surprised that she wasn't able to power that through the defense.
About a minute and a half through the first quarter. Now here's Vandersloot. He's guarded closely. And it's blocked by De'Erica Hamby.
On defense, Hamby is so active. Looks for any opening to swat the ball. Blocks the shot.
And the shot counts. She's fouled. That's a chance for a three-point play.
One shot.
Throughout her career, Laquana Williams has struggled with injuries, but she seems to always come back even stronger.
And they've been struggling here offensively.
Bit of a dry spell for sure.
Pass to Dolson. Back to Vandersloot. Rebound by the Aces.
That's 4 misses on their first 5 attempts. Still trying to get into the flow offensively.
That one drops 4.
Looking good so far. Made all 4 of their shots to get it going.
Now here's Vandersloot. Outside Parker. Dolson. Liz Cambage with the defensive effort. Here's Wilson. The shot, no good. Good work defensively by Candace Parker.
4 or 5 to start their game. That's their first miss.
On the wing, Diamond DeShields. Grabs the miss. The Aces leading. No luck on that one. So Chicago will take it the other way. Here's Vandersloot. Outside Quigley. Outside to Shields. Just 5 to shoot. Once again, off the mark by Chicago. Pass to Wilson. Terrific assist and a nice finish. Just a solid play all around.
Love the selfless, intelligent play by Hamby. Puts the ball into the wide open shooter's hands.
Now here's DeShields. Quiet so far offensively, searching for first points of the game. Outside Williams. Pass to Gray. Here's Cambage. And it's good. 2 points.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. Just phenomenal ball movement.
Everyone's looking for the best shot, and it's paid off during this run.
Now a timeout called by Chicago.
Yeah, coaches, they saw their team giving up a lot of points and wanted to get a break before it got out of hand.
And that's a big part of a coach's job, making sure you keep your players in the best position possible at all times. That's a great timeout.
of bounds. Chicago will retain possession.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
The Shields. She's covered by Hamby. Pass to Dolson. Parker with the ball. Shoots over Wilson. Parker's shot's good.
She came into the league just doing this, scoring. And more than 10 seasons later, Parker still a top scorer in the WNBA.
Raquana Williams goes in. And two shots coming up at the line as she gets fouled on the shot. And that's going to be a foul on Chicago. This is her second trip to the free throw line in this one.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one falls for her. She gets them both. And so it's Chicago with it. 11-point game. Outside to Shields. Over Hamby. That one off the back iron and out. Left side Plum. Hamby outside. Offline with a three. And it's the sky ball. Pass to Shields. Finally, she gets one to fall. She's now 1 of 5 with her first make.
Good persistence. Took her a while, but she gets one to fall.
Now Plum. And the layup's good off the glass.
Hey, look, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting in the paint, and they keep scoring points.
And you know, Brian, there's not really a lot you can do with the defense when they keep getting in the paint like they have been on this run.
Nice pass. She got that ball right into her teammate's shooting pocket, and it yielded great results.
Williams with it. Now guarded by Dolson. Count that bucket.
Of their last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is smash-mouth basketball, guys.
Yeah, they're really imposing their will offensively and getting exactly the kind of looks they want.
Here's Copper. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. The basket counts and one. She'll go to the line with a chance to make it a 3-point play.
In the 2008 WNBA draft, Candace Parker came with loads of hype out of Tennessee. And guess what? What'd she do her rookie year? She won MVP.
Now here's Plum. With some arc. That's her second shot and her second basket. My math says that's 2 for 2.
They've worked hard and created great chances for themselves in this opening frame.
If they match that effort at the defensive end, look out.
Here's Copper, stolen by Essence Carson. Kelsey Plum drives in. Down it goes for her third basket in as many tries.
And there are more points onto an early lead that just keeps on growing.
And a nice lead it is, and it's no mystery how they've done it. They are attacking that bucket. The teardrop is one of those, oh no, oh no, oh yes, shots.
Pass to Young. Plum over Parker. No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
They haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the boards.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game.
Now here's Parker. She's got 5. They get it again. And she battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket. The Aces leading. Pass to Young. Carson. Now here's Plum. Here's Paris. Down to five on the shot clock. Lays it up and banks it in.
Yeah, they're allowing a sky-high field goal percentage. This just isn't going to cut it if they want a chance at winning this game.
Not at all. You rarely see a team surrender points this easily. I mean, effort-wise, execution-wise, something. They've got to do better.
Here's Copper. Looking for her first basket still in this one. That shot off.
Great defensive anticipation to get in the perfect spot.
Pass to Paris. Young. To the paint. There's the foul. It's on Little. That is her first foul of the game. Here's Paris. Can't get it to fall, and she's missed her second after making her first.
And they need to be consistent with their effort on the boards. I mean, just take a look at the box score. They're at a definite disadvantage.
Yeah, and time will tell how big a factor that becomes in this game, but if you're the coaching staff, it's certainly something to emphasize.
Here's Paris. Now Plum.
Not pretty. Gotta just shake off a miss like that.
Pass to Boyd. Stevens. Here's Parker. Drops in the layup for two.
Using her height to her advantage inside, Parker just pushing her way through it all and capitalizing.
And we've reached the end of the first quarter. The Aces on top, up by six. And we'll be back in just a minute with the start of the second quarter. They want my way, they want my way. Guys, what's your take on the Aces so far?
Lots of running to start the game here.
It's a tempo that they like, and they're getting some easy buckets in transition.
Sky Trail. Pass to Quigley. Little. And here is Vandersloot. Five to shoot. Back to Little. Copper. And the three off target. Outside Young. Here's Wright. Let's go with a three. Allie Quigley grabs the miss. Down low. That's tipped. Wright with the steal. Here's Gray. Second shot opportunity. Right, no good. Here's Copper. She's guarded by Wright. Back to Quigley. Little. Pass to Vandersloot. Right side, Stevens. And the first shot of the night for her, missing. And here are the Aces now. They haven't allowed any points in the second quarter.
Coming into the league as a great passer, Young has that radar on her, knowing where everyone is on the court.
Now here's Vandersloot. She's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard.
They need to get way more disruptive defensively. They just can't keep allowing these easy buckets. You know, get a little physical, show some effort.
Defensively, that's job number one. Effort, nothing easy inside.
And we're about 2 minutes into the second quarter here. And it's Gray missing. Here's Chicago now. They trail by seven. Pass to Stevens. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. Liz Cambage picks one up.
Yeah, I love seeing bigs like Stevens that shoot well from the free throw line. And to me, it's really just a testament to their quest for perfection. They want to have all parts of their game be efficient.
First free throw is good.
Yeah, selected to the WNBA All-Rookie Team after an impressive first year. I would say Stevens has a bright future ahead of her, wouldn't you say?
And good on both. And here are the Aces now. They held a 12-point lead earlier. Pass to Wilson. Cambage. Gray with it. Vandersloot defending. Gray outside. Just for a shoot. Goes back up. And Cambage lays it up and in.
Great work by Cambage, standing at 6'8". It's not too far for her to go from rebounder to scorer.
Now here is Stevens. Pass to Quigley. Now here's Vandersloot. She's guarded by Williams.
You're making things far too easy for her if you let her get the ball that deep in the post.
Agreed. I couldn't have said it any better myself. You know, you've got to do your work early and keep her out of that spot.
Now here's Hamby. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. They get it back. A nice shot by Cambage.
They've really turned on the intensity, tracking down those caroms and stacking up second chance buckets.
And those hustle points are just another reason they're out in front.
Outside Quigley. Pass to Dolson. No good on the three. The Aces leading. Rukwana Williams goes in. Here's Wilson. The shot's good.
Look, it's no secret that rebounding is all about effort. And that's something Wilson never lacking.
Now a timeout called by Chicago.
Well, they want to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and now's the time to do it.
Yeah, there was clearly some things going on out there that the coaching staff just wasn't a fan of.
On defense, the Aces. They've only given up six here in this quarter. Here's Vandersloot. Chicago again missing. Hamby outside. And the ball out of play. The Sky will have it. Here's Vandersloot. Pass to DeShields. Here's Endor. To the middle. The shot is good. Allie Quigley making the play.
Even for a player like Quigley, who is known for her ability to score, you have someone that open, you can't miss her.
Hamby outside. Outside Plum. Six on the shot clock. Cambage. Six for six. She's yet to miss from the field.
When she's giving her team this kind of effort and efficiency, they are just so tough to beat.
Pass to Vandersloot. Shoots over Wilson. It's hauled in by the Aces. They held a 12-point lead earlier.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass.
It certainly wouldn't hurt. Some extra possessions would definitely help narrow the gap.
Now here's Williams. He's got seven. from outside the arc.
And it's Courtney Vandersloot with the rebound.
Pass to DeShields.
Back to Vandersloot.
Buries it from three-point range.
Shooting a lot more threes here in the second.
And given their percentages, I'm not sure what they're doing. They've struggled to connect from outside.
Now here is Hamby. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Charity stripe shot.
Williams can't get it to go.
The sky trail. Here's DeShields. That one's good. Maybe that'll get her going after a 2-for-6 start.
Showing some physicality on that play. DeShields is terrific at finishing through contact.
Now a timeout called by Las Vegas.
Coach saw the players were getting winded and called time to give them a quick breather.
A foul called on Brittany Boyd. That's her first foul. Right outside. Six to shoot. Back to Plum. From deep three-point range. And it's Carson missing.
Jeez. I mean, maybe she was just trying to show off right there.
And instead, it had the opposite effect. That just made her look foolish.
Pass to Cambage. Carson.
Now here's Plum.
And there's the defensive 3-second call.
And she's got her first opportunity at the line here tonight.
One shot.
And so she hits the technical free throw.
After a decent rookie year in 2017, Kelsey Plum made huge strides during her 2018 sophomore campaign. Her stats were significantly better, particularly shooting percentage-wise.
Now here's Young. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Here's Paris. That one falls.
Nice find from Young. Her 6 feet height helps her get clean passes off, gives her a great view of the court as well.
Here's Copper. Gets that one to drop. First of the game after 4 straight misses.
4 of their last 5 makes came off a high-quality shot inside.
And that's right out of the textbook. They're having their way down low right now.
Young shot's good.
Excellent use of the 15 or so footer for a point like Young. Hitting these opens up the floor.
Pass to Copper. Here's Endor. Offensive board. Parker, good.
Not only is the game neck and neck, but the rebounding battle is too. Very tight game on the boards.
Yeah, both teams have put in a terrific effort down low.
Young, and it's good. Assisting on the play was Kelsey Plum.
They're leaning on the three-pointer in the second quarter.
And it's letting them down as they've mostly been off target.
Here's Little. A beautiful reverse layup.
Found the soft spot in the D right there.
The Aces leading.
Pass to Plum.
Good work defensively by Brittany Boyd.
Fast break Chicago. 2 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
Now the Aces with it.
They held a 12-point lead earlier.
And here's Plum. She's got 7.
The tray.
And the first half comes to an end. We've got a close game going on here. The Aces on top, leading by a point. We'll be right back to the action when we return. What can you say? Parker, just an impressive effort here today.
Her play in the first half was very disciplined, very efficient. Her shot selection was consistently excellent.
That's right. And whether it's been from mid-range or in tight, she's taking only what the defense is giving her and not trying to do too much.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Vandersloot outside. Pass to DeShields for the lead. It's not going to go for her. Nice defense from Asia Wilson. Bambi outside. And here's Wilson. Some solid defense from Candace Parker. Three-pointer Diamond to Shields. It's hauled in by the Aces. Here's Williams. Count the basket.
Attacks the foul with fearlessness. Williams refuses to shy away from contact.
She's made all of her free throws to this point, 3 of 3. Trail. Vandersloot outside. It's Stephanie Dolson, high post. The shot will not fall. And Las Vegas the other way now.
3 straight misses here to start the second half. Is that good?
Gray up top. Goes up, high post. And she gets a jumper to drop.
An excellent cutter who plays well without the ball. Defenders have to lock in on Gray.
To Quigley. Vandersloot left side. And once again off the mark by Chicago.
A donut. A zero so far to start the second half. 4 straight misses.
And that one's good. Great.
They're doing some work here in the second half. 3 for 4 from the floor.
And they're looking for some kind of spark here.
Yeah, cold stretch offensively. They need a bucket.
Good on the shot.
And this offense needed that one after 4 misses to start the half.
Now the Aces with it. They've only allowed 2 points so far in the second half. Pass to Cambage. And here's Williams. Guarded by Quigley. From 11 feet away. And stolen by Courtney Vandersloot. Here's Parker. Liz Cambage with the rebound. And that's a foul called on to Shields. That'll be her 2nd foul of the game. Just under 2.5 minutes into this third quarter now. Pass to Wilson. Bambi. Gray with it. Cambage. Over Dolson. And count the basket. She was fouled, and she's going to the line for 1 more.
What I like about Cambage is she knows her role, plays to her strengths, and doesn't play outside of herself.
Andersloot outside. Pass to Stevens. Rejected by Liz Cambage.
Well, controlling the boards, they're plus five in that category.
Yeah, and look, rebounding, it's not a glamour stat, but you look at the scoreboard and you see the results. She has shot the ball exceptionally well as they built this lead for themselves.
Timeout called the Sky. Here the Sky. 11-point game. Outside Stevens. Pass to Quigley. Just five on the clock. Now here's Vandersloot. Chicago again missing. To the inside. Back to Gray. To the wing on the left. Here's Wilson. Rebound Chicago.
You just assume she's going to knock those down when she's as open as she was there.
Here's DeShields. Stevens. It's good. And the assist that time from Diamond DeShields.
And the feed courtesy of DeShields. You know, she's really known as a scorer, but Diamond is also solid at moving the basketball.
Now here's Williams. She's got 12. Pass to Gray. There's the three. And that's collected by Diamond DeShields.
Okay, look. I know she isn't having the best of games from the floor, but it hasn't seemed to hurt them.
Quigley's shot's good.
When a shooter like Quigley gets one off the pass, it allows them to feel comfortable, increasing
timeout,
the probability of a make.
Now a timeout called by Las Vegas.
Coach thought the players were looking a little tired and called the timeout to give them a chance to catch their breath.
Teams will make substitutions. Chicago on D. They trail by seven. Pass to Carson. Now Wilson. She's guarded by Stevens. Clock at six. Endor with the rebound. Outside Boyd. Now Endor. Yes, and it's Brittany Boyd picking up the assist.
Running effective pick and rolls is only a small part of what makes Boyd a premier point guard in this league.
Now here is Carson. 18 feet out. Offensive rebound. And Wilson gets it to go.
Absolutely relentless. Ajo Wilson is not someone to allow some contact to get her. Too strong.
Pass to DeShields. Another shot. Here's Endor. couldn't take the lid off. They had their chances, but came up empty. And that one dropped.
The quicks of Gray on display, but also her skill moving fast and finishing a break is not easy.
Stevens, she's guarded by Wilson. Pass to Copper. Defense from Asia Wilson. Inside. Basket good.
Few players better than Wilson inside has a rare combo of touch and length plus the desire to beat you.
Time called here. The Sky decide to talk it over.
Yeah, I think the coach is trying to take the wind out of their sails here. They're on the wrong end of a run and need to short things out offensively and defensively.
Yeah, things were starting to spiral out of control on them a little bit, and a timeout was a no-brainer there. Yeah,
exactly, Brian.
Teams making some changes here. Here's Copper. 5 points in the game. Pass to Endor. Back to Boyd. Copper. And it's good for two.
Ran her defender straight into that screen to open up the lane to the hoop.
Gray with it. She's got eight. Harris, she's guarded by Stevens. Now here's Young. And Wilson gets it to go.
It's a plus five advantage for them in the rebounding category after that one.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior. Really a well-rounded effort overall.
Now here's Boyd. And the basket is good.
A clever decision maker in the pick and roll. Boyd keeps defenders guessing.
Pass to Gray. Wilson. From the stripe, Young shot's good. Here's Copper. 7 points in the game. Outside Boyd. To the inside. Stevens takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely.
A 6'6 forward with just straight up versatility. Stevens has been a noteworthy WNBA prospect for a while.
Now here's Gray. 8 points for her. Azaray Stevens with some nice D. Chicago trailing here. They grab their own miss. By Asia Wilson.
And the timing Wilson has blocking shots is special. Gets good positioning and uses her length to deny shots.
Plum. She has seven. Pass to Young. Wilson. Parker defending. Here's Plum. Off target from outside.
She has slipped into a real funk here.
Definitely. The basket is not looking very big to her at this point.
Here's Paris. Second chance shot. Stolen by Brittany Boyd.
They don't need to rush it. They can play for one shot.
They should wait until about the 5 second mark before getting started.
Absolutely.
And so she draws the foul on the shot.
trip to the line to shoot two.
You don't want to get in the habit of letting the offense get right to the rim.
And that's the message they were sending with that foul, saying nothing easy inside with that one.
Yeah, but they got to play a little bit better defense
shoot
before
two.
They get inside.
The first one falls. And so she hits both. And here's Plum. From about 16, and it's good.
But hold on. The officials may want to take another look at it on the replay monitor. And not so fast. The officials are going to look at the shot again and make sure they got it right before we go into the fourth quarter.
And they've overturned the call. The replay was conclusive, and that one's going to count.
Good thing we have the replay to go to. I don't know what kind of impact it'll have on the final result, but you always want to get every call right. Glad we were able to review that one.
And that's going to do it for the third quarter. The Aces on top. They're up by 6. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of quarter number 4 next. And thanks for joining us again as the fourth quarter of play is set to get rolling. It's been a close battle to this point. The Aces leading. Pass to Wilson. Now Cambage. Outside Plum. 6 to shoot. Vandersloot with the steal. Here we go, one-on-one. It falls for her 7th bucket of the contest. She's 7 for 9 today.
Come on. You think a little contact is going to stop Candace Parker? No way. Too strong. Too much desire.
Now here's Cambage. Right side Plum. Cambage. Rebounded by Parker. 60 ticks off the clock here in the fourth. Pass to Quigley. Nice D from Laquana Williams. 3-pointer Kelsey Plum. Doesn't go for her.
Not her best game, but they're getting it done collectively.
Vandersloot rejected by Liz Cambage. Here's Wilson. And they're going to count the bucket and send her to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
Picks in the draft face a lot of pressure, but Wilson is laser focused and has remained composed.
Pass to Parker. And we've made our way through just over a minute and a half of this fourth quarter. Dolson with it. 5 on the clock. Back to Vandersloot. Shoots the 3. The shot off that time. So Las Vegas will take it the other way. They held a 12-point lead earlier.
We didn't see much from her the first half, but she's making up for lost time.
And they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
Pass to Quigley. Vandersloot outside. Up and in on the
timeout,
layup.
Timeout.
You know, she's pretty comfortable inside. Vandersloot has practiced scoring near the rim so much, and she's as good as any point guard in the league at scoring inside.
Now a timeout called by Las Vegas.
Just under 2.5 minutes gone by now in the final quarter. Pass to Hamby. Cambage guarded by Dolson. Back to Hamby. Fires for three. Here's Wilson. Lays it up and in off a nice reverse.
We've seen an obvious improvement out of her since halftime. She just didn't really have a whole lot working for her in the first half.
Here's Copper. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by the Aces.
Well, she had 1-3 in the first half, but so far in the second, she's come up empty. When the 6-3 Hamby gets going off the bounce, watch out, she can be hard to track.
Misses the free throw.
Back in the 2019 playoffs, De'Erica Hamby hit the WNBA shot of the year, a half-court buzzer beater for Las Vegas, winning an elimination game against Chicago. Go online, look that one up, folks. It was amazing.
And that trip coming up empty, missing both. Outside Quigley. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Shot clock at 5. Here's Vandersloot. Man, that one hits back iron.
Not her best performance scoring the ball thus far.
Over to the left wing. Williams, guarded by Dolson. From 8, a double is Cambage. And a bit of a battle for the ball, and the official signals a jump ball there. Aces with the ball. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And another miss by Las Vegas. Vandersloot with it. Picked up by Plum. Quigley, good.
Whenever Quigley gets a look from range, watch out. As good a shooter as there is in the world.
Pass to Williams. Plum. Let's a floater go, and the shot is good.
Well, you can bet the defense wasn't expecting that kind of razzle-dazzle out of her, but the spin worked like a charm, and that charm worked perfectly.
And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot 2.
Can't let Parker catch you out of position defensively. She's too good at taking advantage of opponents' mistakes.
Shoot 2.
And she makes the first.
They've made every free throw here in the second half.
And look, Tim, you know better than anyone, that efficiency is so crucial when you're looking to overcome a deficit.
She hits both from the stripe. The Aces leading. Gray with it. Wilson outside. Williams takes the 3. It's good, and with that basket, she is now 5 for 9.
Yeah, she's really turning around this half, shooting at a high percentage from the field.
Pass to Quigley. Now Dolson to the paint. Parker, and she lays it straight in.
Another bucket for Parker. She can be the focal point of an offense. Just take a game over.
Out to the wing. Outside Williams. Add basket number 6 to her stat sheet. She's now 6 for 10.
That's such a feel shot. Sweet floater.
Vandersloot with it. Working on Wilson. And the call will be against Liz Cambage. That's foul number 2 for her. And out of bounds, the Aces will take it.
I think she was surprised to see that pass coming her way. She reacted too late.
Gray. Down low. Here's Cambage. Count it. And she's now 8 of 9 from the field.
They're finding lanes to the hoop every time down. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Or at least some fight.
Vandersloot, good.
And she had one in the first as well. And look, we all know that she can be dangerous from downtown. So the defense can't forget about her.
Now here's Gray. Pass to Wilson. Good work defensively by Candace Parker. On the wing, Diamond to Shields. The shot is good. Allie Quigley making the play.
Because of her advanced offensive skill set, DeShields' teammates trust her to come through in big moments.
Now here is Hamby. Pass to Cambage. Over Dolson from 6 feet out, and he nails it.
3 consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The defense better start buckling down.
They're getting exposed and punished down low.
You can just tell Vandersloot isn't afraid of the spotlight. She enjoys coming through for her team in big moments.
Here's Hamby. Candace Parker with the steal. Here's DeShields. The putback. She hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Well, DeShields is able to create second chance points for her team because of her go-getter attitude on the offensive boards.
And the Aces call time here.
Coach saw that the players were getting a little run down out there. The timeout should give them a little energy back.
Here's Wilson. That shot is good. She's taken 15 and made 10 from the field tonight.
When you need Wilson the most, she almost always delivers. Has a sense for the important moments.
Now here's Vandersloot. Pass to Quigley. 5 on the clock. For 3. Rebound by the Aces. They held a 12-point lead earlier. Williams can't get it to go. Chicago trailing here. To the middle. Parker. And yep, it's good.
Worth the price of admissions. Parker's mental toughness carries her to success in big moments.
Refuses to let the high-stake shaker and six it.
Now here's Vandersloot. Gray defending. Pass to Parker. Outside Quigley. Launches a 3. That one, no good. The Aces go the other way with it. Here's Wilson. Good, and it's Chelsea Gray who picks up the assist.
A smart player with good intangibles. Wilson's a consistent scoring threat whenever she's out on the court.
Timeout calls the sky. steal, and she commits the intentional foul. They double her with Dolson. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession, so we'll have a jump ball. And it's the Aces with the ball. Now here's Gray. She's guarded closely. Five to shoot. Down low, Wilson. And she takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
What vision from Gray. One of the top points in the league. She does not miss open teammates.
Time called here. The Sky decide to talk it over. Guys, what do you think?
They get a game plan all they want in the huddle, but unless they put more time on the clock, this one's over.
Yeah, I don't know what they think they can accomplish with this timeout.
Maybe a drink of water?
Vandersloot. No good on the quick three. Here's Young.